Hello, one and all, and welcome to our short on classes. We'll see here why we should create classes and the syntax we can use to do so. Now, I have here a program called packages.py, whose goal is to really track packages we're sending between different users that we have. I have here a list called packages, and notice how it has two packages represented as strings inside of it. I have one, package one, Alice to Bob, 10 kilograms. Another one, package two, Bob to Charlie, 5 kilograms. So two different packages here inside of my list. Now, there are a few different reasons we probably don't want to be using strings to represent these packages here. Now, one of them is strings are flexible, but arguably too flexible. I could very easily change the ordering that I have for each of these pieces of information about a package. Here, I did follow this same pattern of maybe package, number, colon, sender, and then recipient, comma, weight, but I could very easily stray from that as I add more and more packages. I might want something that's a little more rigid, can store information in a better way. So, thankfully, I do have at my disposal this thing called a class. Now, a class operates a bit like a template that I can use to create various objects in my code. I could think of each of these packages as being some object. In fact, I could literally look in the real world and see a package as some object. And I could think of my class as being a template to later create some object that looks a lot like a package, but a particular package. So, here, I have some pieces of information about this package I probably want to encapsulate to put inside my template. One might be the ID of the package. Is it 1, 2, 3, some unique ID to refer to it later on. I might also want to store the sender of the package, as well as the recipient, alongside of the weight as well. So classes, these templates, allow me to encapsulate this information in a single place and not worry about all this different formatting that I have to maintain consistently in my code if I were to use something like a string, for instance. So to create a class, to create this template for a package, I could literally type class, just like this, followed by the name for my class, in this case, package. And by convention, these class names tend to begin with uppercase. So here we have capital P, package. And I could later on fill in this package. But here I'm getting started on creating this template for some package that I can then use later on to create particular packages. So let's think about what a template for a package might ideally store. Well, to do so, I need to first create this particular method, one called dunderInit, which allows me to use my template, my class here, to later on instantiate or create some particular object from this template, from this class. So here, I'll define, in this case, dunderInit. Dunder stands for these double underscores here. And it turns out that this, by convention, must take at least one argument, one called self. When I create, later on, a new object, this self refers to the instance, that new object I'm creating when I were, for instance, to call something like package. We'll see that later on. The other thing this really wants to probably take as input here is all of the pieces of information I need to create some new package. Well, we said down below, we want to encapsulate or really combine a few different pieces of information. One is the package ID, one is the sender, and one is the recipient, and one is the weight of the package here. So I could go ahead and say as input to this particular template that I have here, creating some new object later on, I'll go ahead and say each package has a number or some ID. It also has a sender, a recipient, and in this case, a weight. And this is my dunderInit method. It allows me, in this case, to specify what information I'm encapsulating as part of this template. In this case, all packages have some number, some sender, some recipient, and some weight. Now we might see where self comes in. Within this dunderInit method, I could actually go ahead and try to assign to this new instance of my object everything I've passed in down below. I could say self.number equals number, self.sender equals sender, self.recipient equals recipient, and self.weight equals weight. Now, This might be a little bit confusing at first, especially seeing self and especially having made up some of these actual pieces of information down below. But let's see what it could do for us and maybe walk through what's happening each step along the way. So I want to rewrite my code on line 10 here. This is not what I should be doing to represent packages, but I do now have this template that I'm able to use to instantiate, to create various objects, in this case, individual packages. Well, down below here, let's try doing just that. I'll remove these strings, and I'll then go ahead, and as input to my list, well, I'll create some new package. And I can do so, in this case, by typing my class name, package, followed by parentheses. And now here is where I can actually use those arguments I gave to dunderInit. When I use package parentheses, I'm actually, at least on one step of the way, calling dunderInit to create for myself some new instance of this template. Well, we said here that this should take beyond self number, sender, recipient, and weight as arguments. So I can do this. I could say, well, my first package's number is 1. And it's the sender. The sender is Alice. The recipient, in this case, is Bob. And the weight in this case, will be 10. And so this is the way we've now defined some new instance of this particular class, a given package that has a number 1, the sender Alice, the recipient Bob, and the weight 10 for 10 kilograms. Let's go ahead and add in another package, another instance of this class. I could type package again, and I'll say number equals 2, sender equals Bob. Maybe recipient here was Charlie as before, and the weight of this package was 5. And so this is here our way of representing that second package in our list. And now we have a much more methodical way of storing or encapsulating this information thanks to the class we've created above. But now let's see what this was doing here. We said self.number, self.sender, self.recipient, self.weight. Well, later on, we'll actually see if we can access these things called instance variables, but we'll see that in another short. This then was our short on classes, how to create them, and the syntax to do so. We'll see you next time.